Hey there, welcome back to Equity Masters Stock Market Wrap-Up. I am Rini Mehta. July was the worst month for the benchmark indices in nearly 17 years. The week began with the bad news for the industry as the entrepreneur and founder of the coffee chain CCD committed suicide. The markets witnessed bloodbath by the end of the week. The current scenario begs the question whether we will see the rebound anytime soon. Well, to understand that, we first need to look at what is driving the markets lower. In today's podcast, I'll be taking you through what moved the markets over the week. So let's jump right in. Let's begin with a look at the broader cues. In an already beaten down market, Thursday's carnage on Dalal Street dragged indices to fresh 5-month lows, with the BSE Sensex slipping below the 37,000 mark. On the other hand, Nifty breached 11,000 mark in the intraday trade. Mixed corporate earnings, weak domestic and global cues, and continuous selling by foreign portfolio investors were among the key reasons for the fall. A sharp 41 paise fall in rupee against dollar has made the matter worse. The domestic currency on Thursday fell to a low of 69.2 level against 68.79 level in the previous session. A weak rupee eats into the takeaway profit of FPIs and hence make investment unattractive. Now let's look at the top moves of the markets in the week gone by. In the news from the automobile sector, shares of automobile companies were witnessing selling pressure, with Maruti Suzuki, Hero Motor Corp, Bajaj Auto and Ashok Leyland hitting their respective 52-week lows on weak demand and regulatory headwinds. Reports state that the government has proposed an increase in vehicle registration fees. The Road Transport and Highways Ministry has proposed in a draft policy that buyers would not have to pay registration fees for new vehicles if they present a scrapping certificate. Now, last week on Friday, the government proposed amendments to motor vehicle norms to allow scrapping of vehicles older than 15 years in a bid to spur adoption of electrical vehicles. Meanwhile, the country's largest car maker, Maruti Suzuki, reported 36% decline in passenger vehicle sales in the domestic market at 98,210 units for July. Meanwhile, Bajaj Auto registered a fall of 5% in total sales in July 2019. Automobile sales have fallen every month for almost a year now, except for October, when the numbers were flat. In June, 9 out of India's 11 main passenger vehicle makers reported a double-digit decline in vehicles in sales. However, it is interesting to note that despite the slowdown in the auto sector, the sales volume of electric vehicles are growing at a robust pace. The recently announced government incentives will give a further boost to electric vehicle sales. The coming 1 year will be a real test for India's auto companies. It will also tell us if this slowdown is temporary or if there has been a structural change in the sector. In fact, as per the co-head of research Tanushree Banerjee, this is a key technological catalyst for the rebirth of India, which she is closely tracking. In fact, one such stock is one of the 7 stocks she has picked for her premium subscribers. Tanushree will be talking about the rebirth of India and the 7 stocks in an exclusive online summit on 8th of August at 5 p.m. So if you guys wish to attend the summit, you just need to log on to rebirthofindia.in to book your seat now for free. Moving on, the government of India may look at listing of life insurance corporation. The move is part of the Modi government's next big bang reforms. Reports stated that talks on listing of LIC are at an early stage and an IPO may be planned going forward. As per the news, the government was looking at 2 different views on listing of LIC. A public listing will make it transparent and better run, while at the same time, it will also turn the insurer bottom line focused and make it hard to bring down life insurance premiums. LIC holds 2/3 share of India's life insurance market in India. ICICI Prudential Life Insurance, SBI Insurance, General Insurance Corporation of India and HDFC Life Insurance are some of the companies from the insurance space that have already got listed on the bourses. Now, how this development pans out remains to be seen. Meanwhile, we will keep you updated on all the developments from this space. Moving on, shares of Coffee Day Enterprises hit a lower circuit limit of 20% during the day when the founder V.G. Siddhartha went missing since Monday night. As per the alleged letter left by the founder, he could not take any more pressure from one of the private equity partners, forcing him to buy back shares, a transaction he partially completed 6 months ago by borrowing a large sum of money from a friend. The letter also stated that there was a lot of harassment from the previous DG Income Tax in the form of attaching companies' shares on two separate occasions to block out Mindtree deal. Sikka Logistics share price also hit a lower circuit of 20% as Siddhartha held 0.68% stake in the company. He held 32.75% stake in Coffee Day Enterprises, out of which he had pledged nearly 71.4%. Moving on to the news from the global markets, the Federal Reserve cut interest rates on July 31 to shore up the economy against risk including global weakness, but the head of the US Central Bank said he did not view the move as the start of a lengthy series of rate cuts. Speaking of the US Fed policy decision effects in India, one of the key reasons foreign investors poured money into India was the shift in monetary policy stance by the US Federal Reserve. The US Central Bank, until some months ago, was on track to hike interest rates and shrink the Fed balance sheet. But seeing signs of slowdown in the economy and the nervousness in the stock markets, it showed its willingness to turn dovish. So it's unlikely we'll see any interest rate hikes by the US Federal Reserve in 2019. In fact, the Fed may resume its easy money policies if the global economic slowdown persists and the markets get jittery. One of the key triggers for the ongoing market correction is the escalation in the US-China trade war amid increasing fears of a global slowdown. After the Fed's rate cut, market participants will watch out for RBI's monetary policy stance next week. So will the RBI cut the rates? Let's wait and watch. On that note, I will stop here. And before I sign off, I would like to know whether you like our podcast. Is there anything specific that you would want us to cover? We would love your feedback. Just visit equitymaster.com and drop us a line. We look forward to hearing from you. Thank you and happy investing.